What a beautiful day. I think I brought the California weather here to New York. Commissioner, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, I accept this high honor today, not in my own name, but on behalf of millions of persons around the world who gather around radios and televisions, have come to love this great game as I did 40 years ago when I began my baseball career broadcasting with the Los Angeles Dodgers. Because Cooperstown is where the best of the best are honored, I am humbled by this great tribute. It is a long road that I have traveled from my native Ecuador to arrive at this spot in the shadow of the temple of this grand game. When I started in 1959, I barely knew what baseball was, let alone who the Dodgers were. It is a mark of the Dodgers that they were pioneers in transmitting the call of their games in the language of our Hispanic fans. When I first heard that I had been chosen to call the play-by-play, I was given a year to learn the game. That is when I first observed the magical talent of my dear friend and colleague, Vin Scully. The guidance and inspiration that Vin has so generously extended to me since the first day we met are key factors in whatever success I have achieved. As a Hispanic baseball broadcaster in the United States, I am mindful of the reach of my voice and the impact of my words on millions of Latin American brothers and sisters. They not only share my love for baseball, but also look at this great country as a place where opportunity abounds, as it does in baseball, to those who are willing to apply devotion and hard work. It is a great source of pride to me to have witnessed the ascent of Hispanic ball players. When I began my work for the Dodgers, there were few in the big leagues. Today, they stand out among the best. Their accomplishments have become the stuff of legends. Who can forget Fernando Mania, that captured the hemisphere when the great Dodger pitcher from Mexico, Fernando Valenzuela, came to the scene? We must continue to spread the appeal of this beautiful game to all corners of the earth, as the Dodgers have done. Baseball should not take a backseat to football, basketball, or other sports in the hearts of the peoples of the world. There is not even enough time for me to thank the many persons who have helped to get me where I stand today. But for some, time must be made. The O'Malley family, Walter, Peter, Terry, and their families have distinguished themselves for their vision and generosity. I will forever be grateful to them, as I am to the Calvinson family, owners of KWKW. To those with whom I have shared the booth, René Cárdenas, Miguel Alonso, José García, and Rodolfo Hoyos, I extend my thanks for their professionalism and friendship. To my parents, who are no longer with me, there are no words to express my gratitude. With all my heart, I thank my wife, Blanca, and our children, Jorge, Jimmy, and Mauricio, who over the years, as Vin Scully has said, have paid the bill of loneliness and separation while I am away. God has blessed me in so many ways, but save for the blessings of my family, none is greater than his wonderful gift of allowing me to chronicle this marvelous game. Please give me 2 minutes to say a few words in the beautiful Spanish language. I would like you to know that this, for the first time in history, this ceremony is being broadcast live on radio thanks to the facilities of Lotus Communications Network, Caracol Network, Pulvi Eventos Deportivos in Mexico. We are carrying this live broadcast to all over our hemisphere. Cambiar de horizontes es dar un sancho a la vida, pero nunca iba yo a pensar que algún día dejaría mi tierra, mis pasos y me iban a traer eventualmente a este templo máximo de un deporte cabal, maduro y depurado como es el béisbol. 50 años atrás dejé el Ecuador, donde vi el primer nevado, el primer arroyo, el primer océano, y vine al encuentro de un mundo nuevo que me extendió un brazo generoso. El paso del tiempo llena los vacíos y orienta los senderos. Es así como el inmigrante que buscaba un ensanche para su vida resulta ser hoy día el primer cronista latinoamericano que recibe en vida su entronización al Salón de la Fama del Béisbol. Diríase que entre béisbol y Ecuador hemos llegado a un entendimiento. En el curso de mi formación profesional he tenido inolvidables experiencias, hallazgos notables en valores humanos, desde los mentores de mis primeros pasos hasta colegas, administradores y directores que poseían un valioso caudal de experiencia y estaban dispuestos a compartirlo. De ello he aprendido y quisiera que lo tuviera en cuenta las nuevas generaciones que llegar a un objetivo no es cuestión de fórmulas, sino de iniciativa y que a su vez una firme de nuestras iniciativas nos llega a iluminar con un valioso don llamado visión de futuro. Abrumado con tan festivos acontecimientos, voy a hacer una pausa en mi jornada para aceptar con humildad este homenaje en mi nombre y en el de mi familia. Puesto que Dios hace que cada cosa llegue a su tiempo, solo me cabe pensar que todo es obra de una voluntad suprema. Como dice el capítulo 3 de Eclesiastés, hay un tiempo para cada cosa y un momento para hacerla bajo el cielo. Muchísimas gracias. I would like to acknowledge the presence of so many members of my family and so many friends. A group of 75 people came all the way from California to be here today. Another group came from New York, about 60 people. Friends from Miami, about 15 of them, and some people from Ecuador also. To all of them, my gratitude. Thank you very much. God bless you. Que Dios les bendiga. Muchísimas gracias.